Howdy folks, fixing to do a hydro test on an air compressor tank, and I've got this rig built up here. We'll class this as an adapter which should not be made. Pressure wash to refrigerant gauge manifold. Now this valve here is a bypass valve, it just dumps water. The connection here will go to the tank we're testing. By manipulating those valves, I can create a very controlled amount of pressure up to the limit of the pressure wash pump. And this pump will unload at about 5,000 pounds. So from free flow up to 5,000 pounds is possible. Now I'm gonna demonstrate the test rig here. You're gonna have to forgive the harsh lighting. The sun is at my back and I gotta do this outside. So I've got this valve wide open for free flow through this bypass hose. So we're not gonna see much pressure on the test gauge. So here goes the pump. You can see that it's just a stream of water coming out. Now, try not to spray the camera or the control panel. As I restrict it, pressure is coming up on the gauge slowly. ...150, 200, 250. You see it's very controllable. So by modulating this valve, I'll be able to stress test the air tank in a controlled manner. A friend of mine brought this compressor over, wanted me to try to get it going. I told him that I would on the one condition that the tank is tested. So we don't have any kind of explosion. Because when you compress air, it stores a lot of energy in the air. And if the tank fails with air pressure in it, there have been fatalities. So we're going to test this thing. The test pressure for it is 1.5 times rated pressure. So it's going to be 244 PSI test pressure. The first thing to do is to fill the tank up with water all the way to the top and eliminate the air to avoid any kind of stored energy from the pressure test. So there's an open fitting right there, and I'm going to run the pump until the tank is full of water. So just gonna let that fill until water starts coming out. So the tank is completely full. You can see the water coming out right here. Now I'm gonna install this fitting. I don't have a plug for it, so best I can do is put this check valve in here that's an inlet only from the compressor. So that should allow me to build pressure on the tank. Now there could be some leakage out of that check valve. I don't know how good it is. Try to get this on the screen here. So 245 or 244 pounds is the pressure for this tank, the test pressure. I'll explain more about that, where I got that later. And I'm trying not to hose myself. The pressure pump is a positive displacement pump. Pumps a fixed flow of water. So as long as I leave that open, the pressure is really low. So here we go. We're going to start building it up. 245 PSI. That's rated right there. All right, that's pretty much test pressure. Trap it in there. So now I've got the pump free flowing again, but we've got the test pressure in the tank. Don't see any leaks coming out. Check valve is good. What do you know? A success. So started putting the compressor back together. Still shy a few parts, so not gonna really be functional tonight. Just to further explain the reasoning behind this testing the tank, this compressor had been out of service for decades, been sitting in a barn, and had some water in the tank. So there's a very good chance that the tank had rust in it. These tanks have been known to explode and sometimes kill people. So it's very, very important that you know the tank is going to withstand the air pressure in it. There's really no way to know if the tank is compromised without stressing it beyond where it'll ever be stressed in service. And the typical standard for that is 150% of its rated pressure. So this tank has a data plate on it right here, and it says 163 PSI working pressure. So time and a half of that is what I used. That was the 244 pounds for the pressure test. When the compressor runs and it's pumping air in the tank, it's an energy storage device. You're taking electric power through the motor and the belt, and you're storing that energy in the tank as compressed air to use to drive, you know, an impact gun or a paint spray or anything you're going to drive with it. Because there's a lot of energy stored, if the tank fails, it's going to be very catastrophic. As soon as a tear forms in the bottom, that initial tear isn't going to relieve the pressure on the rest of the tank. It's going to start releasing air, but it only takes milliseconds for the entire bottom of the tank to split open. And the air pressure will provide force on the tank, even after it started ripping at this end and tearing open, to completely unroll the entire tank wrong side out and throw it, send it flying with the motor and pump attached to it. And there's been some really graphic videos you can find of these kind of small air compressors exploding. So here's some pictures. This is a failed tank. You can see that sharp edge blown out from the energy release when the tank failed. Wrecked the guy's garage. Here's a quick Google image search of what can happen. All these are tanks that are rusted inside. You can see the wrecked garages. There's one where both ends are folded out and it's completely unrolled. So this is the thing that we're trying to avoid by ensuring that these tanks are tested. As you can imagine, that flying through the air with those sharp ripped edges, just what that could do. So this is why you gotta take old air compressor tanks very seriously. So when you fill it with water, because water can't be compressed, the water doesn't store energy. You fill it up with water and then gradually apply the pressure, but you're not storing any energy because you're not compressing the water. So if the tank fails, it'll split in a small area and just start spraying water out. It's not an energetic failure. So you push it up to this test pressure, 150% of working, in a controlled manner with water and no stored energy in the tank, and you try to either prove it's safe or induce a failure. Now, there are a lot of other types of hydrostatic testing where you gain a lot more information. You could put the entire tank inside a container of water of known volume, or with graduations on the side. And as you pressurize the tank under test, you're looking for a rise in level of the water. You can actually measure the amount of expansion. And when you release the pressure, you look to make sure that it returned to its normal size to ensure that it's within an elastic range and it's not plastically deforming from the pressure. A lot of really scientific things you can do with pressure testing, but what I did to this was just a quick and dirty, we'll call it a proof test. We proved that at 150% of rated pressure, the tank is not going to rupture. And this, the machine as a whole is rated at 125 pounds, 125 PSI. So there's even a lot more margin for the machine as a whole versus the test pressure. So I'm confident if it took 240 pounds, that 125 is perfectly safe. So I'm going to get a relief valve that's just the next pressure above 125. It'll go in that middle port. And then also the pressure switch is broken. I'll have to replace that. But set the pressure switch to 125, the relief just above it, and this will be safe to use. So hope you all have enjoyed seeing me test this tank and start to put it back together. Thanks for watching.